ജീവന് മുക്തിപ്രദം ദേവം ക്ഷമാപൂർണം ജഗദ്ഗുരും വന്ദേ പരമഹംസാഖ്യം നിത്യാനന്ദായ സ്വാഗതം. ജീവന് മുക്തിപ്രദം ദേവം ക്ഷമാപൂർണം ജഗദ്ഗുരും വന്ദേ പരമഹംസാഖ്യം നിത്യാനന്ദായ സ്വാഗതം. ആനന്ദാനുഭവാസ്വാദം സർവരോഗനിവാരകം വന്ദേ പാപവിനാശക്തം നിത്യാനന്ദായ സ്വാഗതം. ആനന്ദാനുഭവാസ്വാദം സർവരോഗനിവാരകം വന്ദേ പാപവിനാശക്തം നിത്യാനന്ദായ സ്വാഗതം. നിത്യമുക്തം നിർവികൽപം ധ്യാനലോകപ്രദീപകം
പരമഹംസ നിത്യാനന്ദ ఈ శతాబ్దపు మరువలేని పోలికలేని ఒక ఆధ్యాత్మిక శక్తి, ఒక అంతర్జాతీయ సాంఘిక ఆధ్యాత్మిక ప్రభంజనాన్ని స్థాపించిన ఒక అద్భుత శక్తి, వైదిక ధర్మాన్ని పునరుద్ధరించడానికి ఉద్భవించిన ఒక చైతన్య శక్తి. ఆయన అతి పవిత్రమైన తిరువన్నామలై క్షేత్రంలో జన్మించారు. ఒక యోగిగా జన్మించి తనలో సహజంగానే పొంగిపొరలే ఆధ్యాత్మికతను కోట్ల మందికి పంచుతూ స్ఫూర్తినిచ్చే ఒక అమోఘ శక్తి. అతి పురాతనమైన యోగా విద్యలో ప్రావీణ్యం కలిగి ఆధ్యాత్మిక శాస్త్రాన్ని క్షుణ్ణంగా పరిశోధన చేసిన ఒక మహాద్భుతమైన అంతఃప్రపంచపు పరిశోధకులు, ఆత్మజ్ఞానాన్ని ప్రసాదించే గురువులు. ప్రతి సంవత్సరం పరమహంస నిత్యానంద ఆయన జ్ఞానామృతాన్ని, ఆనందం వెదజల్లే ఆయన చిరునవ్వుని, తిరుగులేని ఆయన దీక్ష యొక్క శక్తిని 1 కోటికి పైగా ఉన్న ఆయన శిష్యులకు పంచుతున్నారు. ఇప్పుడు పరమహంస నిత్యానంద మీరు జీవన్ముక్తులుగా జీవించటానికి తోడ్పడే పరిష్కారాలను మీకు అందజేస్తున్నారు. ఒక మరువలేని ఆధ్యాత్మిక అనుభవం కొరకు మమ్మల్ని వెంటనే సంప్రదించండి.
వేద వేదాంత సంవేద్యం దేవదేవీ స్వరూపిణం వందే వటపలాశిస్థం.
All you need is a just simple common sense without elongating your confused logic. I give you a powerful technique for intuition. When you are in a trouble, just look simply with a simple open eyes, decide, you will be successful. Arjuna goes on, I do not know which is more important for us, whether we win them or they win over us. These sons of Dhritarashtra, after killing whom we would not like to live or standing, in front of us, ready to fight. I feel so bad to see Arjuna's situation. I do not know which is more important for us, Arjuna is telling. We win them or they win over us. These sons of Dhritarashtra, after killing whom we would not like to live, are standing in front of us ready to fight. Arjuna's logic is completely confused. He is in chaos. Don't put your attention inside your inner space, which is constantly making you think, like making chains. Don't create chain link of thinking. Open your eyes, see the simple logic. See, reduce the energy you put in the inner space, which goes on thinking in its own tangent, is the way to achieve intuition. Small story, this is a very powerful story. This can make you completely understand what I mean by the word intuition. One university scholar is helping a student who want to do PhD on logic. The student goes to the scholar and asks, "Sir, I want to do PhD on logic. Can you be my guide?" The scholar says, "The subject seems to be too big. I will first test you. Then we can decide whether I will assist you or not." The student says, "Yes, sir, great. Come on, you start the test. I have a confidence I can win." The scholar starts. From one chimney, two guys come down. One fellow's face is dirty, the other guy's face is clean. Who is going to wash the face and who is not going to wash the face? Naturally, the guy said, the student said, the fellow with the dirty face will wash his face. But the scholar says, no. When they come down, the fellow with the dirty face will see the fellow with the clean face and he will think his face is clean. The fellow with the clean face will see the dirty face and will think his face is also dirty. So the fellow with the clean face only is going to wash his face. The student says, wow, I did not think of that. It is shocking to me that I could make an error in logic. Test me again. Please give me one more chance. Anyhow, the teacher again starts. Two men come down from a chimney. One comes with a clean face and the other comes out with a dirty face. Which one washes his face? The student says, we have already established that the one with the clean face washes his face. The teacher says, wrong. Each one washes his face. Examine the simple logic. The one with the dirty face looks at the one with the clean face and thinks his face is clean. The one with the clean face looks at the one with the dirty face and he thinks his face is dirty. So the one with the clean face washes his face. When the one with the dirty face sees the one with the clean face washing his face, he also washes his face. So each one washes his face. The student says, I did not think of that. It is shocking to me that I could make one more error in logic, but please test me again. The teacher again started, holding up two fingers. Two men came down from chimney. One comes out with a clean face and the other comes out with a dirty face. Which one washes his face? This guy says, we now only established each one washes his face. The teacher says, wrong. Neither one washes his face. Examine the simple logic. The one with the dirty face looks at the one with the clean face and thinks his face is clean. The one with the clean face looks at the one with the dirty face and thinks his face is dirty. But when the one with clean face sees the one with the dirty face and does not wash his face, he also does not wash his face, so neither one washes his face. Student is desperate. He says, no, I am qualified to do PhD on logic. Please give me one more test, just one test. He groans when the university scholar, when the logic guru lifts his fingers again and says, two men come down from a chimney. One comes out with a clean face and the other comes out with a dirty face. Which one washes his face? This guy says, just now we established neither one washes his face. Why don't you go to some other test? Again, the teacher says, wrong. Do you now see, my dear student, the programming knowledge is insufficient basis for studying the logic. Tell me, how is it possible for two men to come down from the same chimney? And how is it possible for the one to come out with a clean face and the other with a dirty face? Did you not see a simple thing with open eyes? come on, this last statement is intuition. How can two men come down from same chimney and one be with a dirty face and the other be with a clean face? I tell you, the method of awakening your intuition, I am giving you a very important teaching. I can say this confusion and dilemma is the oldest problem in the world. The moment God reflected himself as a soul, the confusion started. So out of that confusion, he created women. The way for intuition, do not put your energy on your inner thinking. See, when you are in confusion, your mind goes on thinking. See, now three answers he gave. All three seems to be right. That thinking which goes on like a chain, one link to another, which continuously thinks in the inner space. Usually during those moments, you will not feel like doing anything physically. You will not feel like doing anything actively. And even if you are doing, you will be just mulling over on this. I tell you, stop mulling over. That is what is adding food to the confusion. Straight away, see openly. Hey, how can two men come down from chimney, one with a dirty face, another one with a clean face? Simple open eyes does not understand or allow it. So it is hypothetical problem. So when it comes, let us face. Now the solution is, it is simply impossible. Let us do the next. That's all is intuition. Intuition is not growing two horns in your head. It is removing the thorns from your heart. Intuition is not growing horns in your head. It is removing thorns from your heart. You don't need to grow horns on your head to have intuition. You just need to remove the thorns from your heart. Simple awareness. Just see how every time when you read the first solution, it looks logic. Second solution, logically logical. Third solution, logically, logically, logical.
కల్పతరు మీలోని కుండలినీ శక్తిని తెలుసుకోగల ఒక ప్రత్యేక కార్యక్రమము కల్పతరు. పూర్తిగా ఒకరోజు జరిగే ఈ కార్యక్రమములో ఆరోగ్యకరమైన అద్భుతమైన మార్పును పొందగలరు. అవతారమూర్తి పరమహంస నిత్యానంద స్వామి వారి ఆశీస్సులను ప్రత్యేకంగా పొందగల కార్యక్రమం కల్పతరు. కుండలిని అంటే ఏమిటి? కుండలిని అంటే ప్రతి ఒక్కరిలోనూ దాగి ఉన్న అద్భుత శక్తి. కుండలిని శక్తి ఒక ధ్యానోదయమైన గురుదేవుల దీక్షతో చైతన్యపరచవచ్చు. ఈ కుండలిని శక్తి మీ జీవితంలో అన్ని దశలలోనూ అభివృద్ధికరమైన మార్పులను తేగలిగే శక్తి. అది మీలో ఆరోగ్యాన్ని, ఐశ్వర్యాన్ని, విజయాన్ని, ఆనందాన్ని, ఆధ్యాత్మిక ధ్యానోదయాన్ని కలిగిస్తుంది. ప్రతి వారాంతములో కల్పతరు కార్యక్రమం బిడిది ఆశ్రమంలో నిర్వహించబడును. మమ్మల్ని సంప్రదించవలసిన చిరునామా నిత్యానంద ధ్యానపీఠం, నిత్యానంద నగర్, బిడది 562109 బెంగళూరు. ఫోన్ చేయవలసిన నంబరు 09555000550 లేదా 09618519701. మా వెబ్సైట్ www.nityananda.org.
But only finally, when you come to the understanding of the simple awareness, you realize how your logic is so convoluted. It wants to always keep itself busy, occupied with the problems which does not exist. You feel entertained to work with hypothetical problems. You are not interested in reality. The interest to always engage yourself with the hypothetical problems is what I call maya. I'll define Maya as interest to always engage with hypothetical problems, entertaining hypothetical problems in your inner space is what I call Maya. I can say one of the best definitions I gave for Maya is this: the interest to entertain with the hypothetical problems and feeling you are great by finding hypothetical solutions. Feeling you are great when you find hypothetical solutions is ego. Entertaining hypothetical problems in your inner space is Maya. Feeling great when you find hypothetical solutions for the hypothetical problems is ego. Most of the solutions you carry in your life are the security you feel in your life, thinking that you are intelligent. All those pillars which supports the concept you are intelligent are all hypothetical solutions discovered for hypothetical problems. That is why when you face life, you feel empty. The roof you built on your top does not move with you like an umbrella. The roof you built on your top is hypothetical solutions for hypothetical problems. That will not help you when you travel if it rains. But the simple logic, a simple awareness with which you can find solutions for the practical problems in a practical way is like umbrella. Don't miss getting an umbrella when you are too busy with building a roof for your head. Most of the time, you are too busy building roof over your head and miss simple umbrella. Krishna is here driving my chariot, and he has already promised to my wife, he will take care of all of us. And he has promised to my mother Kundi, he will get all the 5 sons out of the war safely. So naturally, we are going to win the war. Come on, let's wage the war. Over. Simple logic, simple awareness. But he has started empowering hypothetical problems, trying to find hypothetical solutions. Arjuna is caught in Maya, missed the awareness. Small story about the awareness. In a medical college, first year of MBBS, the professor is trying to teach anatomy to the whole group of students. So the dead body was brought, and he says, to become a doctor, you need 2 things. First, you cannot be disgusted anything related to body. You can't have any aversion or disgusting feeling about the body. So telling that, in a very cool way, he inserts 1 finger in the dead body's wrong hole and puts in the mouth and tastes it. I know how it feels even to remember, but everyone wants to become a doctor, so nothing can be done. This is the first lesson. Anyhow, with lot of resistance, finally everyone finished it. The professor looked at them and said, the most important 2nd quality is observation. I inserted my middle finger but tasted the index finger. Now learn to pay attention. You need simple awareness. Understand, life is not about finding hypothetical solution to hypothetical problems. It may be good for psychiatrist business, not for life. It may be good for psychiatric doctors, not for psychiatric patients. Just simple logic. See, if there is a first convolution in the logic, it goes round, 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 finally, it comes back to you and starts eating you. For example, I've seen when I was a mechanical engineer, to make a round with an iron tube, All you need is the first moment you need to bend, that's all. After that, just continue pushing the rod. In few minutes, it will come back and become a circle.
ఒక అవతార పురుషుని దివ్య సలహాను నేరుగా పొందాలనుకుంటున్నారా? ఇప్పుడు మీకు పరమహంసతో ముఖాముఖి.
నిత్యానందం, నిత్యానంద హియర్. ఓ, మీరు బాగున్నారా?
పరమహంస నిత్యానంద మరొక్కసారి పోలిక లేని ఒక విభిన్నమైన కానుకను ప్రపంచానికి
అందజేస్తున్నారు.
ఆయన ఇప్పుడు ప్రతిరోజు ఉదయం ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారమయ్యే సత్సంగంలో మీ ప్రశ్నలకి జవాబు ఇవ్వడానికి సిద్ధముగా ఉన్నారు. ఉదయం 8 గంటలకు మా నంబరు 0802-27-99999కి ఫోన్ చేసే అదృష్టవంతులకు ఆయనతో నేరుగా మాట్లాడే దివ్యమైన అవకాశం దక్కుతుంది. మరియు ఉదయం ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారమయ్యే సత్సంగం ntv.nityananda.org చూడగలరు. Only that first bend, if that first bend does not happen, the tube will be straight. If the small first bend happens, it will become just round. If you are logic, if the first bend happens, it comes back and eats you. If the first bend does not happen, it remains straight. In the story which I gave you about the logic, the first bend is, the student started believing. When two men comes down from the chimney, one with a dirty face, one with a clean face, is possible. That is where the problem started. How can this be possible? It's not possible. It's a hypothetical problem. If I see some situation when two men come down and one is dirty, one is
clean, I'll tell the dirty person, hey, wash your face, that's all, the whole problem is solved. But when you accept the hypothetical problem as real in your inner space, in your visualization, now you are caught and the bar starts getting bent. And naturally, anything which is bending will come back to your tail and it will start swallowing you. The convoluted logic comes back and eats the very root, very origin. Arjuna says, I don't know which is more important for us, whether we win them or they win over us, these sons of Dhritarashtra, after killing whom we would not like to live. Logic can go to any level of perversion if the preliminary convolution is allowed. If preliminary perversion is allowed, it can go to any extreme. So I tell you, be aware, do not entertain, do not engage yourself, do not create interest in chewing, cherishing, analyzing hypothetical problems and trying to find hypothetical solutions for hypothetical problems in your mind. Hypothetical solutions for hypothetical problems, the only enemy for sannyasis or for anybody who wants to become enlightened is cherishing the hypothetical problems and trying to find hypothetical solutions for those hypothetical problems. Thousands of people suffering with this disease. When you try to find hypothetical solution for hypothetical problems, you are so busy with hypothetical problems and solutions, you stop finding real solutions and you get into a big mess of real problems. The convoluted logic, the perverted logic, trying to find hypothetical solution for hypothetical problems is the worst disease on the planet Earth. Arjuna is suffering with that problem. Maybe I can give real name for that problem. Maya syndrome.
It has 2000 crore loss.
To reach at least 1 lakh people per day.